Yeah. LDWMMAC. And salute to the WMMA universe. This is your boy, the Coach. You're live on the Coach's Show. The Coach's Show live. Man, we got Molly Meatball McCann versus Laura Procopio. I know I said it right. Thank me later. Okay, man. This was a fight that, you know, Meatball McCann, man, she came in here and she said she's finna win. Said she gonna piece up Laura Procopio. You know, Meatball was talking a lot of junk. A lot of junk. Now, we're gonna do this again, guys. This is gonna be a comment section. A comment section post fight analysis video. Robert Henry, the poet, says, I love Molly McCann's fighting spirit, but she's just not on that level to me. Yeah. TJ347 says, I see her being on the level of Jillian and Montana De La Rosa. Okay fighters, but not good enough at this level to go anywhere. She can still collect a few more checks, though. Wow. Wow. Okay. Man. that's pretty. Wow. Okay. TJ347 said, back to Meatball. Yep, she's not a very good fighter. Wow. Marcus Bell said, Meatball was turned into a flat meatball. TJ347 again says, ground beef McCann. Damn. Marcus Bell said, Molly can't back up her tough act. Yeah, you know, she talks a lot of junk, man, but it just seems like, man, she can't really back that up. Well, she never has been able to, in my opinion. Let's see, TJ347 said, Meatball got tenderized, and D-Bevel the champ said, yep, Molly got smoked. Basically, man, Molly McCann got dominated, okay? Here's another situation where you have a very good striker that can't defend a takedown. And guys, I'm going to tell y'all, I don't like the age of one-dimensional fighters. I don't like these one-dimensional fighters because they're going to lose. They're going to lose every time to somebody that's adept at taking them down. And you know, when these fighters, that they're one-dimensional, you know, they never know. They can never get off their back. They never can. And that's troubling. If you're a one-dimensional fighter, and if you don't have the other basics of how to do certain things, you're not going to make it in MMA. You're not. Comma Breaker 99 said, Molly, another fighter tonight, not effective on the back. Yeah, he said, Molly is another fighter that's not very effective on the back. She's not. You know, you have some fighters like Juliana Pena or Marion Reynaud that when you put them on their back, they have a rule. They stay active. They don't stop throwing punches. They stay active, and that's why they have so much success on their back. Okay? Marcus Bell says, yeah, right on, Coach. Me either with those one-dimensional fighters. TJ347 says, the age of one-dimensional fighter, which I brought up in my Angela Lee video, Coach, WMMA 1.0 era. Yeah, man. Yeah, but Angela Unstoppable Lee, of course, isn't a one-dimensional fighter. It is what it is, man. Molly McCann did not know how to defend a takedown. She was taken down. She stayed on her back. And Molly spent most of this fight trying to get up. I like the pressure that Laura Procopio was putting on Molly McCann. I like the pressure. She put some really, really, really deep pressure on Molly McCann. And Molly McCann wasn't able to handle the pressure. Molly was constantly backing up, you know. And also, too, Molly wasn't even pumping a jab. You know, a good jab can really deter a wrestler from trying to get you to the ground. Molly didn't do any of that. And, you know, I felt like she was doing a lot of headhunting. My God, man. How much headhunting are we going to do? You know, that's what I was thinking. How much headhunting is she going to do? She was dominated all around, man. I didn't give a single round to Molly McCann. It's just when, you know, Laura Procopio took her down, it was beautiful. It was flawless. And Molly McCann got taken down, what, 6 times in this fight. That's a lot of times to be put down like that, man. That's a lot. You know, so what does Molly do? How does she fix that? You know, a lot of the stuff that she's, mistakes she's making, you can't fix those only, you can fix them only with time. That's the problem. You can only fix them with time. And to me, it just don't seem like she got enough experience on the ground to be dealing with these high-level jiu-jitsu practitioners. She don't have that, you know? And I think her team, you know, they need to be like, look, can you put me up against a couple of soft matches? I'm not ready for a title shot. And when she called out Valentina at one time, I'm like, what did you do? What did you do to even get that fight? You just calling somebody out and you ain't done that. Oh, she was talking big junk. Yep, Valentina ain't never seen hands like this. She ain't never seen a fighter like me, you know? And they all say that. They all say that. Well, Laura Procopio, she won this fight. And she basically did it because, I mean, she was the much more well-rounded, skilled fighter. That's why she did it. Laura Procopio could literally do whatever she wanted to do. She was even, in my opinion, winning the stand-up battle. But Molly McCann, that's another one. We don't know. We don't know if Molly McCann's going to be hanging around the UFC very long. We just don't know. Okay, because she's taking another L. And Molly McCann done took some L's up in here. But you guys, in the comments section, tell me what you think. Let me see if there are any more comments. Nope, that's it. Okay, guys. This is your boy, the coach, the king of WMA talk. Salute to Laura Procopio for easily defeating Molly McCann. I'm done.